Let's take a look at the pitch arsenal for Austin Tibbins-Dirks.
And there it is, right to shortstop. Quick flip to second, the relay to first.
At least waited two pitches for it to happen. We'll take a look at the pitches that he throws and the percentage he likes to use them.
Oh, he gets strike three called on Beltre, and it's a quiet. A lot of really good young talent.
Last week, pitcher did throw a strike.
Lindor takes the next pitch and smashes it out to right over the fence for a home run. It was a lightning bolt just over the fence. Third home run of the year for Rougned Odor, and the Rangers jump out 1-0.
His stroke looks a little bit shorter, a little bit quicker.
2-2 to Gallo. And swings and misses strike threes.
And so they've kept him in the third spot. There you go.
Hitting streak. Ooh, take strike three called.
Could have been. Will be the case for five or six guys.
And one hopper to shortstop. Galvez can't hold it.
Try to catch it. Falls a little bit of a hooking line drive. He can't catch it in the air. So he plays it off to the side. How that can happen in a schedule.
Two stints on the disabled list. Pounds this ball straight up in the air into short left field. Long run for Andrews to get out there, and he makes the catch.
He had it all the way, just got a little bit off balance as he was getting ready to catch it. Pull the ball. Used to be a lot of that in the old days. You don't see it anymore. There's Yankees played 2 years in Shea Stadium. And this was a game that's got a chance.
That ball is poked deep out into the bullpen, and it's a solo shot for Chirinos. First pitch swinging. The Rangers lead 2-0.
Well, off the bat, it looked like a fly ball to right. Then you watch Janker. Then Ross didn't get where he wanted it, right down the middle of the plate. And the guy that gives up a 152 average to right-hand hitters made a mistake. And the hardcore flip games, guys were flipping hard off someone's kneecap.
Now the 2-2 pitch. And a swing and a miss. Strike three. He got him.
Wow, what a big strikeout.
1-2. And a fly ball center field. DeShields ranging back, and he'll put it away. The inning is done. The Padres leave him loaded, and the fans love Austin Tibbins-Dirks.
Instead of just approaching them one way or another.
The other day, all you could do is try to hit the ball solidly. Who cares about the atmosphere?
Chopper over the mound could be two. Odor steps on the bat, throws back to first. Nice stretch by Profar to complete the double play.
He takes by himself, going across the bag. Let's see if Jurickson picks it.
Yep. Four triples. Well, that's strike three called, so DeShields down looking tough. List. 1-2 pitch. And he swings and misses strike three, so it is a scoreless seventh inning. First pitch swinging. Myers drops this one out into left field. That's a base hit. One run is in. Hosmer to third, and Myers with the RBI double gets Diekman's first pitch, swinging a high fly ball out to left field. Playable for Gallo. He'll make the catch. Tagging at third is Hosmer. The throw comes through, but not in time.
That was close.
This ball hit well out to left field. It's going to get down. That'll be extra bases. Padres lead for the first time tonight as Myers touches the plate on the Renfro double. Here's a 2-2. And he swings and misses strike three, so Yates.
21 out of 25. He's blown four saves. 56 strikeouts in 38 innings.
Two men out there, the 1-2 pitch. Here it comes. And a swing and a high fly ball, short center field. Margot coming on, and he'll get there. And Hand indeed does finish it off. Rangers leave a couple. And they fall tonight 3-2, our final score, but Chu keeps the streak going. 39 straight for Shin-Soo Chu. Unfortunately, it would not be enough. So tomorrow, the rubber match in the finale here.